This is Chemical Valley. It's a petrochemical industry that pollutes Sarnia every day. Hearing Ada's story left me in complete shock. The worst part about it was that prior to watching the documentary by Vice, I hadn't even heard of it. People on this reserve have been hospitalized, can't sleep with their windows open, can't plant gardens, and have been breathing in chemicals that oftentimes they don't even know about. There have been multiple cases of spills where citizens have not been notified. It is a dangerous, toxic place that nobody deserves to live in, and it's absolutely appalling that this kind of industry is legal. My immediate reactions were both horror and the urge to do anything that I could to not only help this situation, but other environmental causes as well. Chemicals travel. This is not a Sarnia problem. This is a problem that everyone needs to stand up against. Environmental stressors can lead to serious mental and physical health problems. Stress lowers the immune system and leaves a lot of people vulnerable to sicknesses. This means that on top of the damage that these chemicals are doing to people's bodies, the stress is also affecting the mind, and in turn, even further causing damage to the bodies. Additionally, many mood disorders are associated with environmental stress. Ada's story showed how much this problem can negatively affect both her and the surrounding community. Everyone has the right to live in a healthy environment, rather than being forced to endure a place that is constantly damaging physical and mental health. In relation to global climate change, Ada's story shows that so many people are consuming much more than they need. These factories are causing huge ecological footprints and generate so much waste. Releasing these chemicals contributes to the greenhouse effect, and all these factors can lead to intensification of climate, such as increasing droughts and altering patterns of precipitation. Hearing the story has made me more committed to do whatever I can to reduce my carbon footprint. I want to drive less, not buy so many unnecessary things, and do what I can to help others who may not know where to start. I want to also do what I can to raise awareness about the issue in Sarnia, and I believe that if the word spreads, we can start to do more about this issue. The situation is completely unacceptable, and it is about time we committed to putting a stop to it.